Радион Попов е откъсан лъжския край. Той е бивш полковник от разузнаването и бивш заместник министър на външните работи от квотата на ДПС. Чрез фирма на името на жена си, в сделка с военното министерство, ощетява държавата с 8 милиона лева, за което се води дело. Пред съда, съпругата му Таня Попова потвърждава, че е получила комисионна за сделката от 400 000 долара. В момента господин Попов очаква да заеме посланическо място в Саудитска Арабия. Един живот посветен в служба на родината. Лоял Нада навлиза в пясъците на българската административно-полицейска пустиня, защото се влюбва в България.
So, I didn't go to Bulgaria looking for a job. I was an investor and just I went to Bulgaria by all means of the love to the country and the people. Nothing more, nothing less.
Докато един ден и той научава, че е заплаха за националната сигурност.
Anybody can claim anybody in dance without given reasons. And even a friend of mine in Bulgaria told me, listen, I will tell you something. And you will believe it the rest of your life. In Bulgaria everything is possible. And everything is impossible.
Единствената законна възможност за Уел Наза да удължи престоя си в България и да разбере кого с какво заплашва е да подаде молба за беженец. Но докато очаква отговор на молбата си,
two guys, two police officers from the police economy, from the immigration office, they came, I was holding my passport, I remember with my right hand, and he took my passport and he told me, he gave me two documents in Bulgarian and he told me, please sign here. This is one of them. I told him, what to sign? It's in Bulgarian. I don't speak Bulgarian. I need an official translator. And he told me, you sign or not signing, we're gonna take it to Busmansey. I told him, what is Busmansey? He told me, it's a very good place. You feel yourself like at your home. And the police name is Boniev. I'm saying names because till now I'm ready to meet any person that's facing me. I'm ready for anything. And they gave me here 14 days to appeal against the decision. Da beda, as they say in Bulgaria. They took me immediately to the Busmansey. I didn't have my freedom or my choice even to hire a lawyer. I didn't know a lawyer. I was shocked. I'm a human. I have to... I react myself based on the situation. Believe me, when I went inside Busmansey and they took all of my clothes out and I was absolutely naked. They were treating me like a criminal. And I couldn't imagine what's going on. I never been in a police office in my life. The second day I had a nervous breakdown. They told me I couldn't feel even myself, but they didn't call me even ambulance or a doctor. And by the way, in the room which I was in the hall, in Busmansey, between the bars, I used to have one guy, one man, he's an old man from Turkey. And this man, while he was driving his car got bumped. And he was absolutely burned. All of his legs were burned and bleeding and a lot of things coming from his legs. And even his bed was full of blood and so on. And I was wondering why they don't take him to the hospital. He was not even able to walk. And they say it's a temporary place for departing people. Mr. Boyko Borisov, you are the new prime minister of Bulgaria and you are fighting the corruption. Please, I beg you to have a short visit to the Busmansey. Let's consider any of your relatives or any person close to you go inside. We are all humans. We don't need anything else, nothing else but peace and security in life. If I did something wrong, I was able to be in jail. I don't know how can I call it. For 2 years and 3 months on daily basis, I lost all of the basics of living, the ground that I can put my feet on it. And because of what I love Bulgaria, I trusted that there is a law who's protecting everybody. Sorry to say, after I faced my problem, I can say that the law in Bulgaria, especially against foreigners, is a piece of clay. It's formed between the hands of the authorities with many, many holes inside. only the authorities who formed this law know how to play with it. And we are all victims. We protested yesterday. We need nothing more than justice. If we are threat, why? If you have other reasons, we want to know again why. What's up? We have to know. This is our rights. We are not living in the Stone Ages. We are not living in the communism. Bulgaria is a part of the EU. EU is talking about the freedom, respecting the... Even, for example, if I have opinion against the president, it's my opinion. If I have opinion against anyone, it's my own opinion, unless I didn't make a crime, so I'm an innocent person.
Протестът пред българското посолство и отношението към чужденците в България привлече вниманието на египетските медии. Българският посланник даде пресконференция.
Опита на няколко души, които имат забрана да влизат в България, поради очевидно неспазване на наши законови разпоредби, на някакви административни правила, което се случва, ние ежедневно, ежегодно издаваме около 1000 визи, тук и нашия консул ще потвърди, повечето визи, които издаваме са за бизнесмени, защото насърчаваме инвеститорите и отказа е сравнително много малък. Няколко процента само имат отказ. И затова опита на тези господа да правят опит за протест пред нашето посолство, че България едва ли не спъва и е спирачка за инвеститорите, абсолютно неоснователен, абсолютно лишен от всякакво основание.